My wild Irish rose, the sweetest flower that grows. You may search everywhere, but none can compare with my wild Irish rose. My wild Irish rose, the dearest flower that grows. And someday for my sake she may let me take the bloom from my wild Irish rose. My wild Irish rose, the sweetest flower that grows. You may search everywhere, but none can compare with my wild Irish rose. My wild sweetest flower that grows, and someday for my sake she may let me take the bloom from my wild Irish rose. I close my eyes and picture the emerald of the sea, from the fishing boats at Dingle to the shores of Dunedee. I miss the River Shannon and the folks at Skibbereen, the Midlands and the Moorlands with their 40 shades of green. But most of all I miss a girl in Tipperary town, and most of all I miss her lips as soft as lighter down. Again I wanna see and do the things we've done and seen, where the breeze is sweet as Shalimar and there 40 shades of green. I wish that I could spend an hour at Dublin's churning surf. I'd like to watch the farmers drain the bogs and spade the surf, to see again the thatching of the straw the women glean. I'd walk from Cork to Larne to see the 40 shades of green. But most of all I miss a girl in Tipperary town, and most of all her lips as soft as lighter down. Again I wanna see and do the things we've done and seen, where the breeze is sweet as Shalimar and there 40 shades of green. Where the breeze is sweet as Shalimar and and their 40 shades of green. In a town on the sea, by the castle Dunee, the fairest of all was the Maid Eileen. The bloom on her cheek was as fresh as the dew, and her heart to a young fisher laddie was true. At morn he would sail with the sun and the tide, and he would return to his promised young bride. And there on the shore she could hear it so plain, his voice in the wind singing soft this refrain: Eileen, my Eileen, wait for me, wait, my Eileen. They were to be wed on a Sunday in May, and faith, 'twas a joy to see Eileen so gay. The morning before he set sail with the tide, but he never returned to his promised young bride. Oh no, nevermore was her heart young and warm. Her lover he died, yes he died in a storm. And there on the shore she could hear it so plain, his voice in the wind singing soft his refrain: Eileen, my Eileen, wait for me, wait, my Eileen. Say that her heart, it was broken in two. The lovely Eileen, oh, so young and so true. And there on the shore, they who loved her the best, by the rock where she waited, they laid her to rest. Now many but maidens who wait for their lovers there say that still on the shore you can hear it so plain, his ghost in the wind singing soft his refrain. Eileen, my Eileen, for me, wait, my Eileen. If you ever go across the sea to Ireland, then maybe at the closing of your day you will sit and watch the moon rise over Clara and see the sun go down on Galway Bay, just to hear again the ripple of the trout stream. The women in the meadows making hay, and and to sit beside a turf fire in the cabin and watch the barefoot gossans at their play. For the breeze is blowing o'er the seas from Ireland, are perfumed by the heather as the blow, and the women in the uplands digging cradles speak a language that the strangers do not know. For the strangers came and tried to teach us their way. They scorned us just for being what we are. But they might as well go chasing after moonbeams or light a penny candle from a star. If there's going to be a life hereafter, and somehow I am sure there's going to be, I will ask my God to let me make my heaven in that dear land across the Irish Sea. I will ask my God to let me make my heaven in that dear land across the Irish Sea. She's dear as the shamrock of Ireland that grows in the fields or the sea. Its pleasant green is always seen in the springing of the year. Like a breath of pure April morning from under the mist of the night, it springs anew in the morning dew to fill Irish hearts with delight. I'm dreaming of Dora, my darling, my joy and my pride. Wherever I go, I'll always know my darling's at my side. Her dear Irish eyes always gleaming, her heart ever tender and true. There's none so fair that could compare with Dora, whose eyes are so blue. Her dear Irish eyes always gleaming, her heart ever tender and true. There's none so fair that could compare with Dora, whose eyes are so blue. There's none so fair that could compare, Dora, I love you. Take you home again, Kathleen, across the ocean wild and wide, to where your heart has ever been. Since first you were my bonny bride, the roses all have left your cheek. Your voice is sad when you speak, and tears bedim your loving eyes. Oh, I will take you back, Kathleen, to where your heart will feel no pain. And when the fields are fresh and green, I'll take you to your home, Kathleen. And when the fields are fresh and green, I'll take you to your home, Killarney. Many years ago, my mother sang a song to me in tones so sweet and low. Just a simple little ditty in her good old-fashioned way, and I'd give the world if she could sing that song to me today. Tooraloo-ra-loo-ra, now don't you cry. Tooraloo-ra-loo-ra, tooraloo-ra-la, tooraloo-ra-loo-ra. That's an Irish lullaby. That's an Irish lullaby. Long, long ago, in the woods of Gerthamona, I thought the birds were singing in the blackthorn tree. But oh, it was my heart that was singing, singing, singing with a joy that you were bringing, oh my love, to me. Long, long ago, in the woods of Kernamona, I thought the wind was sighing round the blackthorn tree. But oh, it was the banshee that was crying, 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 and I knew my love was dying far across the sea. Now, if you go through the woods of Kernamona, you'll hear the raindrops creeping through the blackthorn tree. But oh, it is the tears that I am weeping, weeping, weeping for the loved one that is sleeping far away from me. Long, long ago, in the woods of Kernamona, I thought the birds were singing in the blackthorn tree. But oh, it was my heart that was singing, singing, singing with a joy that you were bringing. Oh, my love to me. There's a sweet garden spot in my memory. It's the place I was born in and reared. It's long years ago since I left it, but return there I will if I'm spared. My friends and companions of childhood assemble each night by the score, round and shop. For hours we sat at the stone outside Van Murphy's door. When our day's work was done, we would meet there. Summer and winter the same, and the boys and the girls all together would join in some innocent game. Dan Murphy would bring down his fiddle while his daughter looked after the store, and the music would ring, sweet songs we would sing on the stone outside Dan Murphy's door. Back again my heart oft time wanders to the scenes of my childhood at home. Of friends and companions I left there, 'twas poverty forced me to roam. Since then in this life I have prospered, but oft in my heart I feel so, as memory doth fly to the days that are by and the stone outside Dan Murphy's door. Those days in my heart I will cherish, contented although we were poor, and the songs that we sung in the days we were young, and the stone outside Dan Murphy's door. On the stone outside Dan Murphy's door. God, I were the tender apple blossom that floats and falls from off the twisted bough, to lie and faint within your silken bosom, your silken bosom. As thou dost now. Or would I were a little burnished apple for you to pluck me gliding by so cold, while sun and shade your robe of lawn will your robe of lawn and your hair spun gold. Yea, would to God I were among the roses that lean to kiss you as you float between, while on the lowest branch a bud uncloses, a bud uncloses to touch you, queen. Nay, since you will not love what I were growing, happy day the garden path that so your silver foot might press me going, might press me going even unto death. Ah, might press me going even unto death. If her eyes are blue as skies, that's Peggy O'Neill. If she's smiling all the while, that's Peggy O'Neill. If she walks like a sly little rogue, if she talks with a cute little brogue, sweet personality full of rascality, that's Peggy O'Neill. Everything's planned for a wedding so grand in the spring, I'll buy her the ring. Then somewhere in town we'll both settle down, and all through the day I'll say, if her eyes are blue as skies, that's Peggy O'Neill. If she's smiling all the while, that's Peggy O'Neill. If she walks like a sly little rogue, if she talks with a cute little brogue, sweet personality full of rascality, that's Peggy O'Neill. If she walks like a sly little rogue, if she talks with a cute little brogue, sweet personality, full of rascality, that's Peggy O'Neill. There's a pretty spot in Ireland I always claim for my land, where the fairies and the blarney will never, never die. It's the land of the shillelagh. My heart goes back there daily to the girl I left behind me, where we kissed and said goodbye. Where dear old Shannon's flowing, where the three-leaf shamrock rose, where my heart is, I am going to my little Irish rose. And the moment that I meet her, with a hug and a kiss I'll greet her. For there's not a calling sweeter where the River Shannon flows. Where dear old Shannon's flowing, where the three-leaf shamrock rose, where my heart is, I am going to my little Irish rose. And the moment that I meet her, with a hug and a kiss I'll greet her. And there's not a calling sweeter where the River Shannon flows, where the River Shannon flows.